Sunnahfollowers, protectors of the Sunnah. Sunnahfollowers, protector of the Sunnah.
ولا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم على النبي محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم في العالمين انك حميد مجيد. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, after a few years I'm in the hospital, I'm back now Alhamdulillah with Sunnahfollowers. I'm so happy to be here with Fadlillah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Honestly, this, especially Sunnahfollowers, is a part of my life, my heart, deep in my heart. I always think about it. At least Alhamdulillah we have people following the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And today, inshallah, we'll speak about a very important topic for all of us to wake up what's going on right now all around us. A lot of calamities and hardship and trials and tribulations around us. Here, especially here in Texas, we have The hurricane destroyed houses and killed some people and businesses and so on in Miami, Puerto Rico, Mexico, and so on. It's still getting more and more. That's the calamity. حَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ankabut, حَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا. There is no calamity, no hardship. It's going to be hardship. Just like the people before us, there'll be more hardship right now, especially now. In fact, some of you all, you know what happened to me in the hospital. For a few years, I was unconscious. In fact, I learned from the people what's going on. I see a lot of things happening. And subhanAllah, when I came back home here, alhamdulillah, I went back to my books and read. And I found a lot of signs happening right now. Like now, I want to share some ahadith from you now and some ayat, just to prepare ourselves for tomorrow. Tomorrow, our home, not here in earth, our home, inshallah, in Firdaus with the Prophet. That's what we aiming to the Jannah, inshallah. But to work for the Jannah, you have to work hard. You are extremely hard, in fact. It's calamity. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Mecca only, 12 years. Imagine this. And still in Medina as well. And Sahaba after that. And trials and tribulation happening so on. And now we see a lot of signs happening again. Just to prepare ourselves. Think about this year what happened. Me myself, in 1 year, I went to Iowa. And a brother I love very much. And subhanAllah Rabbil Alameen, I used to wash people. When the people die, we wash them, we bury them. And I visited in the hospital. I saw him in the hospital. A second day in order to see him. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, take his soul. Allah give him rahmah, ya Rabbi. Ameen. And also went back here to Texas. I went to Austin, like 4 hours driving. Alhamdulillah, I went there to see one of my dear brother. May Allah give him rahmah also. But I went to the hospital. I hold his hand. Alhamdulillah, I saw him. He squeezed my hand, in fact. And 12 minutes exactly, his wife, kids, everybody crying. I said, he's good, Alhamdulillah. And he died within 12 minutes between my arm, my hand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him rahmah. And he returned last week after khutbat al-jum'ah, after salat al-jum'ah. I came home. I went to the hospital to visit someone. Visit, alhamdulillah. Then I came home and he died. How subhanAllah rabbil alameen. In 1 year, happening and more and more and more. Really, we have to remember. I see that. I have to remember that it happened to me sooner or later. In fact, in the hospital, I saw myself dead many times. My heart stopped 3 times. My brain stopped. Everything stopped in my heart. Like in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making me alive again. It was a miracle. For the doctors, they gave me 3 months to live. Alhamdulillah, almost 2 years now I'm living, alhamdulillah. The reason actually, not medicals, not medicine or doctor, is dua, one for Allah. Dua for all over, especially my mom. She made dua for me in sujood, and she died in sujood when I am in the hospital. Let me start some ahadith, and I believe you know the hadith maybe, or I share it with you, but to see what's going on right now in our life here. Everybody accountable to himself. Look at yourself. I look myself first. And Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman radiallahu ta'ala anhu abba, and Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu abba, and more of the Sahaba said, min ashrat al-sa'a, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, min ashrat al-sa'a. That's one of the signs. The signs, many, many signs, of course. A lot of signs happened, and something right now, and something tomorrow didn't happen until the last day of the judgment. We will be sooner or later, my dear brother and sister. Our life is very simple. Very short of period of time. Yawman, aw ba'da yawm. One day, we're talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We say, kam labith, how long, this was the Baqarah, how long, qal labithu yawman aw ba'da yawm. I maybe one day or part of the day. Allah Azza wa Jalla qal, bal labith mi'at aamin thumma ba'atha. 100 years he died. 100 years. Al-Uzayr, rahimahullah ta'ala. Some people will say he's a scholar, he's something, he's a Nabi, and Allah knows best, he's a Nabi, that's what we learn. 100 years, my brothers and sisters. Look at ourselves, sooner or later, we didn't meet that day. Min ashrat al-sa'a, and that I choose this one because I believe all of you, the student of knowledge. I am a student of knowledge, you are a student of knowledge as well. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من أشراط الساعة يقبض العلم يا الله the knowledge will be removed. Now my dear brothers and sisters, where is the real alim around us? Around us, go to the masajid and you'll hear people leading the salah, mashallah, beautiful voices, but where's the knowledge? Only voice, only just to say, mashallah, Allah, and that's it. But when you speak about, inshallah, about that, is more about the knowledge, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed it. Well, inshallah, step by step, when how Allah removed this knowledge. Now, my dear brothers and sisters, this phone here, one of the signs, I go to the masjid sometimes, actually. Especially in Salat al-Jum'ah, some people having the Quran in the phone. The Quran in the phone. So if Allah's the phone, that means There is no Quran to write. The knowledge, my dear brothers and sisters, is not in the phone. The knowledge in the books. Books to write. One day, one of my shiuch, I used to travel from America all the way to Saudi Arabia just to learn. And subhanAllah, I used to record because we have recorded. We don't have a fantasy time now with a cell phone and this and that. And then I used to record, just record and listening to the Sheikh. And one day, I cannot find my recorder. And in this case, I say, he asked me, Ibrahim, what are you looking for? I said, my recorder, I had to record your lecture. I said, okay, it's not here. Right, right. He's there, Dawin, Ibrahim. Right, right, Ibrahim. And honestly, I take a paper, and boom, I start to write. Since that day, never stop writing, alhamdulillah. And of course, after that, he hide it from me, and he said, see, if you lost this phone, that means you lost everything. And it was the recording, and not a cell phone in that time. See, if you record them, I say, if you not recording, if you lost that phone, what then happen? And he told me exactly, this is one of the signs of the day, the time is going to squeeze. SubhanAllah, we're going to speak about it, inshallah, more, inshallah. Al-ilm, and it's very important, I really want to speak about it more, but inshallah, next time, bi-ibnihi ta'ala. Number two, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tadhar al-fitan, trials, tribulation, calamity, hardship going to happen. Look, my dear brothers, Syria, Egypt, Rohingya, Burma. Look at Burma. And unfortunately, something my heart hurts. Not even one single country, Muslim country, speak about it. They speak about the king and the prince and the president and this and that. But there were hundreds of, not thousands of people got killed in Burma just 2 months ago. I was shocked. Not even Al-Azhar, unfortunately. The one Tadhar al-Fitan. We're going to speak about it even more. But this is happening a lot and every day. Every day in every country, not even Muslim country, every country in the whole world, there is calamity about al-Fitan, trials and tribulations. And also, yuqa al-shuh. Now, countries, I don't want to mention names, they have trillions and trillions of dollars. And but for the poor, they don't have anything. Look at the Africa, Muslims, Burma, here, Palestine, Afghanistan, a lot of tribes, a lot of people in hunger. But unfortunately, the people that have the money, they're having fun now, nothing else. One of the Arab countries, supposed to be Muslim country, to just have hunting, to hunt, to teach him how to hunt, and he shot one bird. That bird cost more than $10 million just to get the birds. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. Nothing else. Either. And also, and this is really important, يقتو الهرج. Killing. My dear brothers and sisters, look at the Muslim now getting killed in Burma, in Palestine, in Afghanistan, in Iraq, in Yemen, in Egypt. You call it. The one with the sign of death. It's got even more. Even more. When those people, when they wake up, when there is real Muslim defending the Muslim, the country, then maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Allahu a'lam. Allahu a'lam. And the last one, my dear brothers and sisters, and that is really sad. يكثر التناكر. التناكر، التناكر يكاد لا أحد يعرف أحد. No one knows each other. No, my dear brothers and sisters. I was in the masjid and sitting after the salah. One brother came to me and said, brother, I have a problem with my wife. And I say, what's the problem? He called me the problem, regardless of the problem. And then I say, before you sleep, what you do? I say, nothing. We just, I am in, she's in a computer. She's in the cell, I am in the cell phone at this. And I told him, she's in a computer, on laptop, or texting, and you have the same thing. And you see, you're fine, you think you'll have a solving the problem is solved. That's one of the tanakur. You don't know each other on the same bed. And the kids, now, look at the kids now. MashaAllah, cell phone, texting, in the masjid. Salatul Jum'ah, I saw some people, I make Khutul Jum'ah, look at the kids, they texting and things. And that is why. I didn't know how to fix it. Okay, inshallah, alhamdulillah. So even texting, one of the signs, the family itself, I know some people, not everybody, of course, not some people, when they want their son or the daughter upstairs or next room, they're texting each other. When they're calling each other, yeah. Subhanallah, texting each other in the same house. Subhanallah, that's one of the signs with the division, the brothers and sisters. And more than that, actually, I want to share with you a lot of things. But let's think about tomorrow, my dear brothers and sisters. Do we really ourselves preparing for that day to come or not? Everybody think about it. Dunya, dunya, my dear brothers and sisters. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Came with Ibrahim, Jibreel alayhi salam, Jibreel. Qala ya Muhammad, عش ما شئت فإنك ميت. Live as long as you want. Live, you're gonna die. Nuh alayhi salam, ألف سنة إلا خمسين عاما, 950 years. Where is Nuh alayhi salam? Where is Adam alayhi salam? Where is Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam? Live, and أقل له عش ما شئت فإنك ميت وحبك ما شئت فإنك مفارقه. Love anyone you want to love. Love anybody. Love عائشة, love خديجة, love. You're gonna live with them sooner or later, you're gonna leave. And then he told me, subhanAllah, وعمل ما شئت فإنك مزي به. And do whatever you want, Allah will give you the reward. Good or bad. And the hadith long. But look, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love him the most. Love him the most. Ya Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Khalil sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Ibrahim alayhi wa sallam. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, just to think about tomorrow, do we really ourselves prepare ourselves? Or not yet. Let us ourselves think about it. Me, my wife, my son, my daughter, my friends, my masjid. And with this hadith, my brothers and sisters, just to think about it, so scary, just we'll lose it if we're not thinking about it. Sooner or later, we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us in the Firdaus with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam without question. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hold us accountable, so scary, my dear brothers, just to think about it. Everybody want to be in a Jannah. I want to be in Jannah. You want to be in Jannah. My wife here, everybody want to be in Jannah. No question asked. But which Jannah you want to be? The first level? The second? Seventh? All the way? The Firdaus? Because the one that is punishment before, and so on, and so on, and so on. My dear brothers and sisters, we have to be Allah mahsin al-khatimah, and may Allah bring our good for our end. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that day, my dear brothers and sisters. And also, one hadith to finish it, and then inshallah next week we'll speak more, bi-ibnillah. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم رب صلى الله عليه وسلم أبو هريرة عن حذيفة رضي الله عنه قال إن بين يدي الساعة between my hands of the hour the sign of the day of judgment سنين خداعات one time you don't know you are confused a lot of flies around us look at the media Every media, I cannot see a real true, some very, very, very few good, and the rest fabrication, just to make money, this money. You know, khadda'at, everybody betrayed. يصدق فيها الكاذب, الكاذب, يصدق فيها الكاذب, that liar, the liar. Everybody believe him, oh, because it's the media. And ويكذب فيها الصادق and the opposite. The one that truthful, everybody lie. And the liar, everybody believe in him. And then he said, this is the end of the hadith. And very important hadith in the end. وينطق فيها الرويضية رويضية رويضة الصحابة رضو الله يعني رويضة a new word in Arabic language what is رويضة يا رسول الله قال ما الرويضة يا رسول الله قال يفسق فيها ويتكلم فيها العامة يفسق فيها ويتكلم بها العامة the one he makes making fatwa making fatwa after making fatwa and that fatwa ضلوا وأضلوا that means they become astray and they make the other astray as well and this is happening right now you see in this different place here in Masajid they know the knowledge but where is the knowledge actually some Masajid I saw myself the Imam make khutbah al-Jum'ah with the phone He reading from the phone, the cell phone. Everybody have a cell phone. But we have a paper we can write down. But the one on the side. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us everything. As ibtila, trials and tribulation, test. May Allah protect us from that day, my brothers and sisters. يتكلم بها العامة يتكلم أنا ولي making fatwa now. Where is the fatwa? The cell phone. Fatwa in the cell phone. Allahu alam, this is true, not true, good or not good. Allahu alam. Because the knowledge. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our knowledge, all of us, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala join our heart together. Allahumma alif bayna qulubina. Allahumma alif bayna qulubina. Allahumma alif bayna qulubina. Ya mu'allif al-qulub. Ya Allah. Ya Allah. And let's start here, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, because I have to go to Masjid for Salat Isha as well. But, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, next week, we'll start another signs happening. Especially, I learned from the people in the hospital. I learned because I was completely paralyzed. I cannot even speak. But I hear and hear stories and stories. And I decide, when Sister Layla actually, Ask me to speak and say, let's sign this one. And inshallah, also next week, I'm so sorry for Monday, I think. Monday or Tuesday? Monday, yeah, it was no electricity in the house and no internet. So we cannot speak, but forgive us, please, and make dua for us. because my wife is very, very hard. She worked very hard just to be this video and organize everything. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Jazakallah khair. But inshallah, we'll speak about next week about the bid'ah. Not the bid'ah, about the love. Right. Everybody loved the Prophet. But how many of us following the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam? That is the key. Everybody loved the Prophet. Let's reach how to love him, inshallah, next Monday, inshallah, Mawla Azza wa Jalla. I stop here, inshallah. I don't know if you have question or not, because after that, I still have 5 minutes to go to the masjid for Father.
Sunnah, Allah, protectors.